Now we're going to use what we've learned about finding slopes of tangent lines to actually find the equation of the tangent line. So in the problem that we're given here, it asks us to find the equation of the tangent line to f of x equals 1 over x at x equals 5. So what do we need to know to find the equation of a line? Well, if we use the point slope form of a line, this is going to be the easiest thing for us to use, then what we need to know is a point and a slope. So the point slope form of a line looks like y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And the way you use this is you put your slope in for m, and then your point, you put the x value of the point here and the y value of the point here. And then you have a perfectly good equation of a line, and it's going to be a lot easier to do than using y equals mx plus b. So what do we need to know? We need to know a point and a slope. Well, which is easier? Probably a point. So let's start with a point. Our point, well, we already know the x value. It's given to us is 5. How do we find the y value? We're just going to plug 5 into our original equation, so 1 over 5. So, as a hint, was f of 5. All right, so that's our point. That was the easy part. Now, what about the slope? Well, the slope is just what we've been practicing so far. So we have the slope equaling the limit as h goes to 0, f of 5 plus h minus f of 5 all over h. So in our case, that is the limit as h goes to 0. So 5 plus h is, we replace x with 5 plus h in parentheses, so we get 1 over in parentheses 5 plus h minus 1 over 5. It's f of 5 divided by h. Now remember that the trick, if you're using rational functions, is to find the common denominator. So we're going to find the common denominator of 1 over 5 plus h minus 1 over 5. Note how I write limit as h goes to 0 on every line until I actually take the limit. That's really important to help you keep track of what you're doing. So the common denominator between 5 plus h and 5 is just multiplying those two together. So if I want to take 1 over 5 plus h and change the denominator to 5 plus h times 5, I need to multiply top and bottom by 5. And if I want to take 1 over 5 and change the denominator to 5 plus h times 5, I need to multiply top and bottom by 5 plus h in parentheses. And then all that is being divided by h. But I don't like having to write all that being divided by h. So a neater way to do it is to make this whole thing times 1 over h, multiplying by the reciprocal. All right, so now multiplying at the top, because notice I'm trying to factor an h out of top and bottom, and I already have an h factored out of the bottom, so I don't have to worry about the bottom. So the top is 5 minus 5 minus h. I'm distributing that minus sign. The bottom is 5 plus h times 5 times h. And I notice right away that I can cancel the 5s on top. That leaves me with a minus h. So now I have minus h on top and 5 plus h times 5 times h on the bottom. So I cancel the h's and I'm left with a minus 1 on top. Minus h, when you cancel the h, becomes minus 1. And my new limit is the limit as h goes to 0, minus 1 over 5 plus h times 5, Now I can let h become 0, so I get negative 1 over 5 plus 0 times 5, which is negative 1 over 25. So negative 1 over 25 is my slope. And I need to take that all the way back up here to the top to my point slope form of my line. So what I needed a point and a slope. So I have a point. It's right here. And I need a slope. It's right here. So plugging that into my point slope form of my line, I get y minus my y value, which is 1/5, equals my slope, negative 1 over 25, times x minus my x value, which is 5. And this is an absolutely fine final answer. Now, if you're using my math lab and it asks you to put your final answer in y equals form, you'll have to move that 1/5 to the other side. But on an exam or something, this is great, and you are done.